Mr. Knightley loves to find fault with me. His brother is married to my sister, and we always say what we like to one another.
Emma knows I never flatter her.
Or I, him. I made the match myself.
I think not.
Point of fact.
I'm unconvinced.
Who could leave such things to chance when I can be exact? My judgment has proven correct.
With all due respect, I would beg to object.
I made the match myself.
I think not.
I joined their hands.
No, still not true.
They're happily united.
Yes, but not because of you.
Couldn't you offer some praise?
I offer the truth. You can't have it both ways.
Please don't speak.
I wouldn't get a word in there
to
wise.
I don't get to be bored to death by you.
I would try to scold you, but you're not even listening.
Do I not get credit for inviting them to dinner? Encouraging
you.
Their friendship, and all while I was eating.
Emma.
Clearly I made the match myself.
Yes, so you keep repeating.
What about our new vicar, Mr. Elton? It would be a shame to have him single any longer. I must make a match for him.
Emma.
Harriet Smith is someone I have long held an interest in. She may be a parlor boarder and not remarkably clever, but with the benefit of my guidance, I believe I can make her deserving of a man of Mr. Elton's esteem.
Yes, I have every faith in your ability to meddle where you do not belong.
I'll make the match myself.
God forbid.
No task so great.
That poor man.
Ask her and I'll hand her to him on a silver plate.
I can
it's
assure
glorious.
He'll find
it's
a wife
crystal clear.
May I just
now
say,
he has me
yes,
to
interfere.
Pity that you do not see what I do. Yes, I